Hello my dear friends, welcome to Python programming playlist. In this video we are going to see another operation that can be performed on the elements of the list, and that operation is nothing but summation of the elements. So given a list, we will be adding, that is doing the summation of all the elements of that list. First let us create a blank Python file with the name sum of list. Here is the blank Python file created. Now this is the problem definition that we are going to see in the video, which says write a Python program to perform summation of all the elements of a list. So we are going to take a list as an input from the user, and we are going to perform the summation of all the elements. And this summation will be performing in two different ways. So first, what we are doing is we are creating a list. Now to create a list, first we have to create a blank list that you can see in this line. S is equal to the empty bracket. Then we are asking from the user that how many numbers do you want to enter in a list. So first we will be taking the number of inputs that we are going to take from the user. Then after that we'll be taking those many number of inputs from the user. So here is the for loop written for that, which says for n in range num. That means this loop will iterate from 0 to num minus 1. That means total number of iteration is num, that is the number entered by the user, and we will take input, and that input is converted to integer and it is there in the variable numbers. This is very important, my dear friends, that the value entered from the user is there in numbers, and that we are appending it to the list S. So the first value, let's say if entered is 10, that will be appended, so my list will contain 10. Then let's say the second value inputted is 20, so that will be appended and my list value will be 10 and 20. So here this method append is important. It is used for appending an element to the list. Now we will be doing the summation. Now to do the summation, we are using a summation variable. So here the variable name is total and its initial value given is 0. So we will take one element at a time and we will add that value to the total. Now to do that, we are making use of a for loop. So for I in S, total plus equal to I. That means from the list, each element will be taken one at a time and it will be added to the total. So first the total value is 0, so it will become I, then next element will be added to I, and so on. Then we are printing the sum of the list. So the print method is written, which is saying summation of all elements of the list is equal to total. So all the elements will be added and it will be there in total, and that will be printed. Now I have already said that we'll be doing this summation in two different ways. So first way was writing this for loop, and the second way is performing summation using the sum function. So there is an inbuilt function with the name sum, and it will do the exactly the same task that is done by this for loop. So we are using that, and we are writing that print sum of the elements in given list using sum function is equal to then sum in bracket list, list name, that is the S. Now let us run this program and see the output. So first it is asking me the number of elements we want to enter. The number of elements entered is 3. First number entered is 5, then 8, and then 7. So if you add up that, so it will be, first it will take 5. So 0 plus 5, the total was 0. So 0 plus 5 is 5. Then 5 plus 8 is 13, and 13 plus 7 is 20. So summation of all elements is 20. And using this function sum, we are getting the same answer, that is 20. So here you can see that there are three elements entered. First element is sum. First element is 5, then it is 8, then it is 7, and we are performing this summation using the total. So here you can see that there are two print functions, summation of all elements in the list, that is using the for loop, and then using the sum function. Now let us run it again, and now let us enter 4 numbers. The first number we are entering 8, then 8, then 8 and 8. So we are entering all the numbers as 8, and the total we know should be 32. So we are getting the same answer using the loop as well as using the sum function. That means the loop that I have written is working correctly. So I hope that this is clear how we can perform the summation of elements of a given list. Thank you for watching this video, my dear friends. Stay tuned for more videos on Python programming.